flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Sunshine Law Statement, all requirements of the Open Public Business Meetings Law have been met for this meeting of the Board of Education of the Borough of Ordinal. Notice that this meeting was filed with the Record and Town News and all persons requesting such notice. Mrs. Shapiro, would you read the mission statement?
Sure, of course. Okay, can you guys hear me? The Ordinal Public School District, a safe and nurturing learning community dedicated to the ongoing pursuit of educational excellence, inspires lifelong learning in its children through comprehensive, innovative curriculum and instruction. The district fully supports and expects the attainment of the New Jersey Core Curriculum Content Standards on the part of all students within the school environment designed to maximize student potential, develop responsible citizens, and promote respect for the uniqueness of all individuals.
Thank you. Roll call.
Mr. Derriam?
Here.
Mrs. Nouriam? Mr. Odo? Mrs. Shapiro?
Here.
Mrs. Walker?
Here.
Mr. Walsh?
Here.
Dr. Westlake? Mrs. Robertson?
Here.
Mrs. Nichols?
Here. Open to the public for agenda items only.
Hi, good evening. Amy Syracuse, 519 High Street. I wanted to ask a few questions about the policy that is up for approval this evening. And I had a chance to review it today. And I had some concerns, and they're centered less on the actual content and the intention of the policy, but more on the fact that as it's written in its current state, it raises a lot of questions, which I think is probably the opposite of what a policy is intended to do. I noticed a lot of ambiguities and things that were left open to interpretation. And I know that, especially on the items that address decorum at public meetings, really the last thing you want to have is a situation where maybe you have a heated discussion and you're making things up on the fly and making decisions that could be perceived as arbitrary. So some examples of the things that I didn't feel were addressed specifically. One is the time limit. It states a time limit on individual comments may be imposed by the presiding officer when there are multiple audience members waiting for a turn to speak. So there are kind of two issues that I have with that sentence. One is the time limit wasn't specified. The second is how do you know that there are multiple audience members who are waiting to speak? I've been to a lot of meetings, I've never seen a line at the podium. So I don't think, if you're gonna do that, there maybe needs to be some sort of system where you can identify how many people that you have waiting. The other clause that I found to be a little bit ambiguous was the presiding officer in his or her designee may interrupt, warn, or terminate an audience member's statement when the statement is too lengthy. So again, what constitutes too lengthy? I don't think it would be healthy for the board to set yourselves up to make a judgment call on that in real time. I think it would be better in terms of your written policy to specify whether that's 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, whatever you think it should be. The recording portion, and I really empathize with you here because I think you're probably having to invent a lot because there's not a lot of precedent out there, and that's really a big challenge. But there were a lot of things that really confused me about this. The first sentence talks about the board secretary may make video or audio recordings. I was under the impression that you were hiring someone to do this, that there was a stipend. So is that in addition to the board secretary, or are those one and the same? The requesting access, that's another place where the writing really was very unclear for me. It states, all video or audio recordings are the sole property of the board, and any individual requesting access to these materials must do so in writing at least 5 working days in advance. So does that mean if you're intending to request access, you need to give notice 5 days before the meeting, or does that mean you're requiring 5 days to process that request once you receive it? Then you talk about the board shall record the public portion of regularly scheduled monthly meetings. I don't think you meet monthly. I know the schedule is a little all over the place and it's twice a month. I know you have several special meetings, including your beginning of the year reorganization. None of those meetings were covered in the policy. You talked about archiving them online for a year, and my next question is there an offline archive? It would make sense, I think, from legal perspective to burn those videos and have them archived somewhere, even if they're not available online, in case you ever need to retrieve them for historical purposes or, you know, perhaps some legal reason. The justifications for editing, again, I understand confidentiality breach. I don't think I've ever seen it happen, but I think it's smart to plan for it. However, I think it should be made clear whether this is the only reason that you would edit or whether there might be other reasons. And also, I think you need to, in your policy, talk about, is there a disclosure for editing? Are you going to give notice that the content that is being made available has been edited? Gosh, the next thing, and I'm kind of really a little embarrassed to bring this up because I never like to be someone who points out kind of like, you know, spelling and grammar errors, but there is a part that makes reference to unintended breaches, and the breaches spelling that you've used is actually short trousers, not a breach of confidentiality. And gosh, lastly was the part about the public recording. And I think this part, to me, was a little bit more thorough. However, there were still a couple of things. I noticed a change in this. I think it was posted in one version earlier today and then replaced later because there had been a clause I initially saw that disappeared, and it was regarding only two people, I think, could record, and it was available on a first-come, first-served basis. And I think, but I just would like to confirm which version is correct. And I was curious about the justification for asking members of the public to reproduce their recordings at their own expense and to provide a copy of that to the Board of Ed. I don't really have a strong opinion. I'd just like to understand where that clause came from. And also, again, just on the desire to be clear and eliminate questions and judgment calls in the moment, the sentence, the board has a right to place a limit on the number of recording devices in use if the recording equipment presents a safety hazard. So I just want to confirm, obviously phones and iPads, those things don't present safety hazards, and I just want to make sure that the limit is only in the case of a safety hazard and not being limited for other devices. So I think those are most of my comments. I did mark it up, and if you decide to revisit this, I'd be happy to you know, summarize those in writing if it would be helpful, because I've run through it kind of quickly. Thank you.
I don't have anything special to report this evening. All of the items are listed in the regular committee business.
Anything for the VA department? Anything for the business office? No, not tonight. Okay. Okay, we're moving to minutes. We have the approval of the August 23rd meeting minutes. Do I have a motion? Rita? Do I have a second? Mr. Walsh? Do we have any questions? Call the question.
Mr. Darien?
I abstain.
Mrs. Norian? Mrs. Shapiro?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
Mr. Walsh?
Yes.
Dr. Westlake? Mrs. Robertson?
Yes.
And Mrs. Nichols.
Yes. Before we move to committee reports, we need to go into a very quick closed session for a personnel item and a legal issue. It will be maybe 5 to 8 minutes at the most, so I need a motion to go into closed session.
Second.
Dr. Westlake and Rita.